The United States has revoked emergency use of malaria drugs for the treatment of the infection that is associated with the pandemic. The United States regulators revoked emergency authorization for malaria drugs that were previously promoted by their president for the treatment of the infection amidst growing evidence that they do not work and could cause serious side effects. The Food and Drug Administration has stated that the drugs hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine are unlikely to be effective in treating the infection. Citing reports of heart complications, the FDA said that the drug's unproven benefits do not outweigh the known and potential risks. Decades-old drugs also prescribed for lupus and rheumatoid arthritis can cause heart rhythm problems, severe low blood pressure, and cause muscle or nerve damage. This move means that shipments of the drugs obtained by the federal government will no longer be distributed to state and local health authorities for use against the infection. The drugs are still available for alternate uses by U.S. doctors, and therefore they could still prescribe them for the infection, a practice known as off-label prescribing. It has been agreed by many that the decision is a good one, and one Dr. Steven Neeson has stated that he would not have granted emergency access in the first place. There has never been any high-quality evidence suggesting that hydroxychloroquine is effective for treating or preventing the infection, but there is evidence of serious side effects. On Thursday, a National Institute of Health panel of experts revised its recommendations to specifically recommend against the drug's use except in formal studies. And also it was stated that he is sure that there is an influence on the Food and Drug Administration. The actions by the Food and Drug Administration and the National Institute of Health send a clear signal to health professionals against prescribing the drug for treatment of the current infection that is affecting the United States. Death rates are 12 times higher for infection patients with chronic illnesses than for others who become infected, as new U.S. government report states. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention report released on Monday highlights the dangers posed by heart disease, diabetes, and lung illness. These are the top three health problems found in infection patients, the report suggests. The report is based on 1.3 million lab-confirmed infection cases reported to the agency from January 22 through to the end of May. Information on health conditions was available for just 22% of the patients. It shows that 32% had heart-related disease, 30% had diabetes, and 18% had chronic lung disease, which includes asthma and emphysema. Among patients with a chronic illness, about 20% died, compared with almost 2% of those who were otherwise healthy. Infection patients with a chronic condition were also six times more likely to be hospitalized, 46% versus almost 8%. People with chronic disease are much more likely to suffer severe effects of infections, but we cannot lose sight of the fact that previously healthy people can also become very ill and even pass off as well. Race and ethnicity data available for just under half of the patients show that 36% were white, 33% Hispanic, 22% Black, 4% Asian, and about 1% of American Indian descent. Though the numbers are incomplete, they echo other reports that found minorities have been disproportionately affected by the infection. Overall, 14% of the patients were hospitalized and 5% passed based on available data. Among patients aged 80 and up who passed, half had a chronic illness. Roughly equal numbers of men and women have been infected, but men were more likely to have severe cases, the report has found. The health minister for Ghana, Kwaku Agyeman-Manu, is currently under medical treatment after he tested positive for the infection. President Akufo-Addo, during an address to Ghanaians on Sunday evening, revealed that the minister caught the virus while on duty. The minister is currently undergoing treatment at hospital. He led West Africa's fight against the infection in Ghana. Ghana has one of the highest number of confirmed cases in Africa because of its robust testing, with more than 11,400 cases. Health authorities have also reported 51 loss of life. News of the health minister's illness further fueled worries as Ghana's universities prepared to reopen on Monday so that students in their final year of study could take their exams. If the minister is getting the disease, what is the guarantee that other persons will be safe? Like, comment, share, and subscribe. This has been a roundup review of current health issues affecting the globe. Leave your comments down below and let us know if there's any other health-related issue or newsworthy issue that you'd like for us to discuss. We wish the nation of Ghana and their health minister the best in recovering from the infection. Remember to subscribe if you have not already done so. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. We crave your feedback, and we will reply to all your comments as you have listed them. Thanks for watching.